That's Jack Montgomery, and to his left, right on the goal line, is number 20, the sophomore fullback Julian Smiley. Modified spread formation. Brownson is the quarterback. The slot back to the left is Frost, number 28. Brownson pitches off over there to Green. He got a good block. He runs to the 50, to the 45, to the 30, to the 25, and he's hit out of bounds. Down around the 22, but they may say he stepped out of bounds further upfield. They're going to call it a step out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. There was Brownson running the option to the left. A great block was thrown by number 28, Larry Frost, who was in the slot just outside the left tackle. He threw it on the cornerback, and the pitch out went to Mike Green. He went down the sideline into Georgia territory to the Bulldogs 37. The ball is a little bit to the left of center of the field, and Rogers comes forward, hits that ball. It's plenty long, and it's good. He hit a 50-yarder right through the middle, and the back really waited up it.
Well, he could have made that from 70 yards. Did he hit that one? It went into the entranceway, which must be another 25 yards back of the goalpost. Rogers really hit that one 50 yards, and he made it with plenty to spare.
He's going to try that field goal again. The ball spotted at the 21. It'll be a 31-yard attempt from an angle to the right, and the kick is up, and it's good. And it's put through there by Rogers, and the score is Nebraska 6 and Georgia nothing.
To the Sun Bowl at El Paso.
And a 31-yard field goal. Two field goals by their junior Paul Rogers, the right halfback from Rock Rapids, Iowa. And now Nebraska will kick it in. Nebraska in the first quarter. The Huskers with the ball at their own 28 now. Come over the football. The quarterback, Van Brownson, has he's rolling back to his left. He's looking for a pass receiver. He pumps and throws long. And the pass is caught far down at the 30. It was complete to Ingles, who got in behind his man, and he was the 27 after making a great catch. He got in behind Billy Darby, number 28, Guy Ingles. Van Brownson made the pump, and then Ingles made his move. Brownson hit him with a strike. Ingles making a great catch as he had Darby by a step. And in one thrust, Nebraska went from their 28 to the Georgia 28. Second and five. And the give this time is to Kinney running over the left side. He's all the way in, standing up for the touchdown. Fine pass plays, then went outside of the left, right over the right side of the Georgia defensive line. That was a good block. Kenny was hit and slowed just momentarily at about the 6-yard line, but broke the tackle and went on in there, standing up as he went into the end zone. And Nebraska has now put a touchdown, and the Cornhuskers from Nebraska will have to try again for a field goal. This one will be spotted at about the 32-yard line. Kicking is Paul Rogers, who already has two on the board. The ball is down, the kick is up, and let's see. It's plenty long, and the referee calls it good. There was a little delay getting the sign as the back judge motioned to Vance Carlson. It is good, another 32-yarder. Well, let's see, this would be 42 yards. It was kicked from the 32, spotted there, plus 10 of the end zone. So this boy now has a 31 and a 50 and a 42-yard field goal, all in the first quarter of this game, where the score is now 15-0, Nebraska.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield coverage.
He's had eight straight winning seasons since coming to Lincoln.
And now with 14 seconds left in the quarter, Nebraska goes for another field goal. Paul Rogers booting, Brownson holding at the 26-yard line of Nebraska. It'll be spotted, a 36-yard attempt. There's Rogers' kick. It's a floater. And is it or is it not good? It's good again. Unbelievably, has kicked four field goals. That was a 36-yard attempt. He has kicked four in this first quarter. And Nebraska has 18 points on the board, and the clock shows just 1 second left to play in this quarter. Only a second left. And I'm sure, Dave Blackwell, without checking it out in the book, I'm sure that must be some side of an all-time record. Don Bryant of the University of Nebraska has just come in. And Dave, why don't you pick up the comment that he's got for us there? It's an all-time record of some sort. Four field goals in one quarter.
Dave, Paul had tied the record dating back to 1914. Vic Halligan had kicked three against Iowa. This is a new Nebraska record, 4-1 ball game.
It's a new Nebraska record, according to John Bryant of the University of Nebraska. I'm sure it has to be a Sun Bowl record. The hip of the left tackle coming around to the right and over his own right side. Larry Frost for the University of Nebraska. Nebraska, the wide receiver to the left, and the give is to Kenny, the I-back, running outside to the left. He's to the 10, to the 8, and down he goes at the 8-yard line. Jeff Kenny started inside from his I-back slot. That's where the hole was supposed to be. He couldn't find what he looked like, what he liked the looks of, so he broke outside and got outside the end. Number 84, McKnight, and was finally brought down. Mike Green blocking for him. He was finally brought down by McKnight. And touchdowns, as they've been all year, is moving in tight. Bronson rolling out. He throws complete, and it's a touchdown to Mike Green, the fullback. Quarterback rolled out to his right. He hit Mike Green, number 34. Green made a fine catch as he had to turn a little bit, reach down and catch a low throw from Van Brownson. But then Kenny went into the air. All right, Georgia, 3rd and 9 at the Georgia 27. Wide receivers out on both sides as Gilbert goes back, throws a little screen, it's intercepted. He tried to dump it over the line. And took that ball that was intended for Julian Smiley. Smiley couldn't get his hands on it. Murtaugh could for Nebraska and ran it all the way back to the 1-yard line, and it must have shattered him that he didn't get in. So Nebraska at the 1 of Georgia, and Brownson on the quarterback sneak is in for the TD. And Nebraska has scored a second touchdown here in this third quarter of the football game. So Nebraska goes over again. They have taken it again on two miscues, two turnovers by Georgia. A fumble and an intercept. And they have turned both into touchdowns. In this third quarter of the ball game, the tie for the point. Rogers kicks when he breaks out and over the football. Larry in there with a tight formation. And the give this time is to the fullback. He's in there. The fullback, Snice, went in there for the touchdown. His way into the end zone, and Nebraska has put another touchdown on the board. And this is the widest margin ever in the Sun Bowl. However, this game is not yet over. It is only a temporary margin, that is for sure. So Nebraska will now try the first time in the waning minutes of this football game. As they break the huddle and they're in the I formation, the quarterback, Gilbert, slides down the line to his right. He keeps the ball, and he's in for a touchdown. So Georgia has scored. They've gotten on the board. I don't know just how much time remains, but the time for the point now. The kick is up, and it's no good. It was off to the left. The attack in the closing minutes of this football game at the Nebraska 26-yard line. And back there to throw is Gilbert. He's got time. The pass is intercepted by Morrell. Morrell trying to run upfield. He's to the 30. He's to the 35 and hit down around the 35-yard line. So a quick exchange of the football as George's Gilbert fired, and Morrell, the sophomore linebacker, cut in front to make the intercept. And that, I think, is either 5 or 6 interceptions for Nebraska this afternoon. The ball is across the 35 to about the 35-and-a-half-yard line. Back in Nebraska possession. So on the exchange of interceptions, Nebraska gained some ground. And now they break the huddle and come over the football. Just 6. Back here at the Sun Bowl, Nebraska just
racking up a
coming back here with Nebraska defeating Georgia. But Georgia, we mentioned earlier that we thought that with the 3-week time differential between their closing game of the season against Georgia Tech and the game today, that some of these wounds would heal, but apparently that wasn't it, because we did not even see Craig Elrod, who's a fine flanker.